Chris Brown and Quavo began beefing in 2017 when it was reported that Quavo had started dating Karrueche Tran, whom Brown dated from 2011 to 2015.
No, 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 no. It's not fucking happening. So, we both know that you know what I do. I don't talk shit. This shit is beneath me. I want to bring black people together. But you gotta get your ass whooped, my nigga. I'm gonna be real with you.
While the former Migos member and Tran never confirmed the rumors at the time, Brown reportedly felt betrayed that Quavo dated Tran, as he considered him one of his good friends. To add fuel to the fire, Tran filed a restraining order against Brown around the time that her dating rumors with Quavo started circulating. According to TMZ, Brown didn't think that it was merely a coincidence and that Tran only filed so she could freely date Quavo. Not long after, reports surfaced that Brown and Quavo's crews had a physical altercation backstage at the BET Awards, but both camps apparently left unscathed.
Hey, check it. This is my good morning announcement. Now we're on this year. All you fake niggas, stop being my fake friends. All you fake niggas, stop coming around downloading my swag. Trying to see what the moves is, what the licks is. Trying to see what the new wave is. All you niggas look like my kids up there. I ain't hating. Y'all niggas stop coming around if y'all ain't real niggas. Cause I know a lot of y'all bitches. You know I ain't playing with this shit.
Nothing came out of the Quavo and Tran dating rumors after, and soon enough, Quavo was romantically linked to Saweetie, while Tran started dating former New York Giants player Victor Cruz. They did, however, stir up dating rumors again in 2022. But Tran denied that they were an item.
Richie, now that it's been brought up, would you be down to go on a date with Quavo? It's like a friend, a friendly date, like see how it
we're
goes.
You're friends?
Okay, friends.
So what's going on with that? Like,
okay, a romantic date.
Aaron, are you good?
Apart from a few social media disses, Chris Brown and Quavo appear to have put their beef aside.
It feels good. I guess this year was like really hard for us, but not hard as far as like competition. Just we had to just go and give it our all. I think teamwork was the key. We got to the bigs. The bigs did their thing. Every guard got their chance to be isolated and do their one-on-one thing. And us cohesively, we all a unit. We gonna kill as long as we on the same mind frame.
Bro, two seasons in a row, Crew Lee, you guys are champions. You know, I heard y'all call some people last year.
Yeah, he was scared. Quavo.
Who's scared?
Quavo, bring your out of here again. I said it twice.
Second time.
Second time.
Everybody.
We had a lot of MVPs, but my boy got it. But we got a lot. I'm talking about everybody on this team.
We all won, yo.
We all was here. We was tired.
Hey, Quavo, get your out here.
Yeah.
We cooking y'all.
Of course. Who next?
But in April 2024, when Brown released the deluxe edition of his album 1111, it included a track titled Freak, which featured Lil Wayne, Joyner Lucas, and T Grizzly, and contained an apparent diss directed at Quavo. Based on the lyrics, it seemed that Brown is still not over how Quavo apparently dated Karrueche Tran. It didn't take long until Quavo released his own diss track titled Tender just a day later. Quavo seemed to have addressed his beef with Chris Brown in one of the verses in the chorus. You did the chick wrong and now the chick gone, she posted with a thug. Call the chick phone, she won't come home, don't beat her up, it must be the drugs, need to cross out your plug, he rapped in the hook. In the second verse, the former Migos member then rapped, Tell me, lil bro, what's your issue? It's over a thought, you said it's bigger than that, but no, it is not. It's cause I be digging in that, it got him hot, he raps. I'm giving respect, but I know you not. Your chick on my neck, your chick at the spot. Then, on April 20th, 2024, merely a week after the release of Tender, Chris Brown dropped Weakest Link, which included multiple disses directed at Quavo. The cover art even featured Quavo biting on a hot dog. He even insinuated that he slept with Saweetie while she and Quavo were still together.
Mirrored Quavo's diss song to Chris Brown. Chris Brown has been since responded. Someone said Drake wrote Kanye's set list. Did he? How we know that? It said Chris Brown responded to Quavo's latest diss. He said that shit don't even need a response. Takeoff rap better. Right? There's actually more response. If you actually go to Chris Brown's Instagram story, he's been posting a lot. Here we go. First thing he said was, yo, Google Raps, that shit is who? Damn, I was excited. That shit don't even need a response. Takeoff rap better. Then he said, come on, Quavius. Then he said, he posted this with Quavo like crying with the weakest link. And then, by the way, interesting playoff weakest link is, you know, I believe, didn't Quavo drop some shit called like Infinity Links? Yeah, right? And he played this shit.
Brother, this guy stinks!
Hey, funny guy, I got a joke for you. What smells rotten and puts people to sleep?
J. Cole.
Noxious.
J. Cole.
Gas?
No! Your act!
Shit.
Hell no! Trash ass
nigga. Oh, shit. And then, I don't know who this is. And bro, did he really say that or am I tripping? He said light skin versus brown skin finna divide the country. And he says bars with the cringe face emoji.
You know how that ended? Won't smoke with me? Always be me fighting over hoes and bitches?
Always be. Nah, this shit, I'm just not feeling this shit. Like, this suck. This suck, bro. This shit ass. I'm not fucking. No, bro. You got 2 minutes and 22 seconds worth of mid. Yo, my nigga. Hey, listen, bro. Listen. Yo, this shit sucks. This is ass. Chris 1-0, bro. Chris is up right now, bro. Go to his Instagram. Yep, GG's.
I'm in Tennessee. Go ahead. What you want to say?
That shit is fucking trash, dog. Get the fuck off the airwaves.
Oh, come
on. All right. Hey, we playing everything. Okay. I'm not going to bias it out. I think it was dope. Oh, they having a poll right now in the shade room. Okay. I ain't gonna lie. Quavo could have been more disrespectful, but I think, you know, it would have probably tainted the fact that it's a good song. Cause if I'm, yo, listen, we all have to remember rap diss songs all started with niggas lying. Let me tell you this. If I'm Quavo, you know what I would have said? Nigga, why are you mad? Cause Karrueche said my dick bigger than yours. No diddy. Be like, yo, why are you mad because Karrueche said I fucked her better than you did, nigga? I would have just lied. Like, I don't even care what she said. I would have just started lying. Nigga, I would have just lied. Fuck that. I would have just started lying.
What do you think of the beef? Let me know in the comments.